call the situation in Mali with al-Qaeda gaining strength and traction, it appears. What kinds of weapons are pouring into Mali from Libya?
Well, the main thing you have to worry about is surface-to-air missiles. What happened was just before the conflict broke out in Libya, Gaddafi had up to about 20,000 arsenal of surface-to-air missiles. After the conflict was over, 5,000 are missing, still unaccounted for. So that's one of the things you have to worry about. Another thing, jeeps mounted with machine guns, lots and lots of ammunition belts. These are prowling the streets, something to be concerned about when you're there.
And so let me just ask you about the question you've been looking at. Victor Boot, obviously everyone has heard of him, Merchant of Death, and now going to be serving time in jail. And you've been investigating, well, when Victor Boot was accosted, who took his place? Because I think as what's clear is happening in Mali with arming al-Qaeda and other places, there are new arms dealers now, right? And what did you find?
Well, everybody's been asking, you know, who is going to fill Victor Boot's shoes? And so I set out on an investigation, a 6-week investigation in Africa and the Middle East, looking to see what Victor Boot's lieutenants were up to. And I came upon two of the top lieutenants, Sergei Denisenko, who had been one of Victor Boot's right-arm men, mm-hmm. and Andrew Kosolapov in an idyllic island in Mauritius, which is a gateway to Asia, Middle East, and Africa.
And they were there. And you were able to track down weapons, the planes, everything they were using. Did you find American connections?
We did. What we found was that because Russian aircraft are aging and also the Russian network wishes to have a new cover of legitimacy, they were trying to source aircraft out of Europe and the U.S. One of those aircraft came from Bangor, Maine. It was involved a company called CNL Aerospace. And what was interesting is when I talked to CNL Aerospace, they said, oh my goodness, on one hand it appears now we're servicing the arms traffickers in Africa, and on the other hand we're servicing American companies that are running black operations in Africa. So that just kind of shows the out of control nature of this illicit arms trade.
And is it getting worse with all of the instability in Libya, in Egypt, in the Middle East right now? I mean, are you seeing sort of an increased flow?
Well, what we're seeing is a revving up mm-hmm. of particular networks. And what they're looking at mostly is trying to place aircraft also in Iran. We believe this is for the Syria context. Still lots more work to be done in terms of the investigation.
Iran theoretically transfer weapons into Syria.
Absolutely. So these are looking, and they're actually, what's interesting, a new development is they're looking to do it with passenger aircraft because no one had suspected passenger aircraft in the past. So what I found Victor Boot's lieutenants doing was trying to source passenger aircraft out of the U.S., out of Europe, to give it legitimacy so that they can make these runs into Damascus.
All right.